The nation of South Africa contains two active volcanoes, one of which was witnessed actively erupting in 2004. As strange as this might sound, it is completely true, but it happened to occur in an area most people do not think of when they imagine South Africa as a country. So, where are these volcanoes? I, of course, am not referring to mainland South Africa, which is home to 65 million people, but rather two sizable volcanic islands approximately 2,160 kilometers southeast of Cape Town, which were annexed into South Africa in 1947. Zooming in, it is easy to see the abundant volcanic features and young lava flows that dot both Marion Island and Prince Edward Island. It might be initially tough to see the exact scale of these islands due to the lack of tall vegetation to use as a source of scale, so I am noting that Marion Island and Prince Edward Island, when combined, have essentially the same land area as Hawaii's island of Lanai. Yet, while 3,400 people live on Lanai, no one lives on either South African island, at least not permanently, as 50 temporary researchers do work on Marion Island's research station. While snow frequents the tallest point on Marion Island, which rises 1,240 meters or 4,068 feet above sea level, it was not so long ago, geologically speaking, that the vast majority of the island was covered in thick glaciers. The advance of these glaciers are why large, figurative bites look like they were cut out of the landscape, as these mark what were originally higher points of the volcano, which were carved away and stripped of elevation by the sheer mass of advancing glacial ice. Also, some of the sediments moved by the glacier were placed as it retreated underneath what is today the research station, hence the rugged topography there. The exact history of when these glaciers existed isn't 100% clear, but we know for a fact that they existed between at least 55,000 years ago and 17,000 years ago. Each of this volcano's darker black-colored lava flows visible from satellite are interpreted to be under 11,700 years old, with an estimated more than 120 such eruptions occurring during this time span. In other words, the Marion Island Shield volcano seems to erupt an average of once a century. These eruptions seem to largely start at or near Marion Island's summit area known as its Central Highlands before propagating in one direction, sometimes all the way to the coast. This is why so many of this island's cinder cones and lava flows seem to follow a perfectly straight line, as in fact their source vents do. This pattern was mostly followed during the island's two historical known eruptions, which in 1980 involved a fissure that propagated all the way to the western coastline and covered 1.05 square kilometers in a layer of lava, while in 2004 a much smaller eruption from a singular vent only covered 0.59 square kilometers in a layer of basaltic lava. Marion Island and Prince Edward Island are both shield volcanoes which rise approximately 5,000 meters or 16,400 feet from the ocean floor. If you were to create a line going north-northeast through these two volcanoes, you would eventually encounter a raised oceanic plateau that runs all the way to Madagascar. This is no coincidence, as this represents volcanism generated by the movement of a mantle plume known as the Marion Hotspot. The mantle plume has essentially remained stationary since its formation, while the overlying tectonic plates have not, hence the visible chain you see. This chain led all the way to Prince Edward Island, which was created first, and Marion Island, which was created second, with both rising above sea level around or before 530,000 years ago. However, while some sources noted Prince Edward Island as producing more than a dozen Holocene eruptions, I could not confirm this data. However, I have noted three potential Holocene vents on this shield volcano island, which has clearly lost the vast majority of its size from what was once a much larger landmass. True landslides might have caused this island to progressively collapse into the sea, creating the 500-meter or 1,640-foot high cliffs that exist over much of the island. While future eruptions could theoretically occur anywhere on either island, or possibly even close offshore, on Marion Island in recent times, lava flows appear to have only happened on the western two-thirds of the island, away from the Marion Research Station. Future eruptions of this volcano will likely be brief and mildly explosive, with minor to moderate ash emissions, with the overall eruptive event likely lasting less than 1 month. Such an eruption will potentially construct one or more cinder cones and fissures from which lava flows towards the coastline and the vents generate up to 500-foot-high lava fountains. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Michael Petzold, for supporting my work.